current directional model. And later we realized that the family index theorem is actually an infinite dimensional version of it. The finite dimensional model is about very simple notions of vector bundles and connections. So we have a vector bundle, complex vector bundle, E over a base space. Everything I'm going to talk about is smooth. But there is an extra ingredient in the sense that these vector bundles I'm going to consider are graded. So it's actually Z2 graded complex vector bundle. This just means that the vector bundle is a direct sum of two vector bundles when you call positive part, whether you call negative part. So this is a vector bundle over a base space, and I assume that we have connections on each of the e plus and e minus. So connections e plus and e minus. So these are, if I may recall, these are first order differential. First order. First order differential operator from the space of sections of E or E plus E minus, depending on the situation, to the space of one fourth of E with values in this vector model. So, and then, so this connection preserved the splitting, then we can put together the two connections. So this is a connection over this is a connection on E. Connection is a first order differential operator, and we call the definition, so it satisfies this condition. Where f is a function on B and s is a section of the vector bundle. So, so this is a connection. And not only do we consider connection, we have, if we take this derivative twice, why can we do it twice? Because we can extend this operator to acting on this space of p-fourths with values in E, and the result is p plus 1-fourth. And now we can take this covariant derivative twice, and if we do that, that is the curvature. Of course, naively, it is a two-form, naively it's a second-order differential operator, but it turns out that the differential part vanishes, and this is a computer algebraic. So it's a two-form with values in the anamorphism of the for an anamorphism, we can take a trace. But when we have a graded vector space, we can actually define the supertrace. So so what is a supertrace? Suppose I have something which is anamorphism valued. So that means on each fiber is a linear map of E. Because of the we can extend this definition, suppose our polynomial omega in which is a P form value to the morphism part. We can always take the super trace on the morphism part. So if I take the super trace, that would be just the usual P form. So these are just notations about the setup. Other questions? So now differential forms also have a degree. Here it's denoted by P. So what I can do is I can connect all the even degree differential forms and call it the plus part. So the set of differential forms of B is even. So this is the set of even degree forms. Also the odd degree forms. So in that sense, this is a infinite dimensional Z2 graded vector space. Then you see that the derived operator D actually act interchanging these spaces. You can even form goes to about 4 and conversely. So with this, with these terminologies, we can now introduce the notion of superconnection. Before I do that, let me say that suppose I look at differential forms valued in the vector number E. So here you see, so you see that the differential form itself is a gradient, so you have a positive and negative part. But the bound of E has its own gradient. So what do I mean by the even part of this space? So it has two possibilities. So one is that we have an even form of B with values in the even part of the vector number, or we have an odd form of B with values on the odd part of the vector number. And similarly, what is the odd part of this? It is, we have one possibility is that we have an even form valued in the odd part of the vector bundle, or an odd form valued in the even part of the vector bundle, or in a combination of those. So now we introduce definition due to Hiller on superconnection. So this is a generalization of the notion of connection, yet it still behaves very much like connection, as we will see, for the purpose of doing characteristic classes, heat kernels, etc. So what is a super connection? So given, of course, we should say given a Z2 graded complex vector bundle, E, which is E plus minus over D. So a super connection is an odd first order differential operator, and the notation that's this to distinguish from the usual phenomena. So, so this is from sort of sections of the bundle, just like here. To the one form of D grounded in this bundle, and such that it satisfies the Leibniz rule, just like over there. So, FS equal to DF times S plus F times the superconduction of S. So F is a function, and S is a section of this bundle. Now, everything here is clear. What do we mean by odd? In this case, it just means that this operator maps the even part of the plus part of the space to the minus part of the target space, and vice versa. So here, now, this is a one form, so we know what is an odd part and what is an even part. So, so maybe I should so in fact what I said is not it's not completely true. So I should allow all the possibilities of the base of differential form because that is what generalized the notion of connections. So is jumping across the part to the minus part of the set, but allow all possible degrees and forms. So we the mistake. So this is, there's nothing fancy about this. The ordinary connection is a notion of is a particular example of a superconnection. So two immediate examples are following. So B is the usual connection. Usual connection. And what I described over there is an example of superconnection. Simply because if I have one here, then I have plus minus, then over minus plus there, then I have to plus minus. The other example is that E is completely trivial. And also connections are also trivial. But then the covariant derivative is just the usual, the one derivative, the one differential. So I can take this as d plus h, where h is an odd degree form. So this is another example. Notions about connection curvature generalized immediately to superconnection. So out of that, I would like to mention that the curvature is also defined as a plane. So I said that one can extend superconnection to an operator from let's say even degree forms. It's even degree, but even forms together with consideration of the degree of B and also the gradient of E to the odd part or the odd part to the even part. Such that this inequality also generalizes. So what we should have is that if I have alpha wedge omega, where alpha is a form of B and omega is a form of B of value E, this should be satisfying the same similar magnitude rule. So alpha is always the standard differential. And then we can argue that if I do this twice, this on the surface it is a second order differential operator, but the derivative part miraculously cancels. And what remains is that it's no longer a two-form, as we will see. It's a form of B with values in the anamorphism bundle, but combining the degree of the form and the gradient of the anamorphism bundle is even. So in these examples, this curvature is the usual curvature. So in the first case, the curvature is a two-form B with values in the orthogonal combo. And in the second case, if I take the square of it, h is an odd degree form, so I have dh, and that is an even form. So this is the curvature of the even form, and a degree in this interval. And it satisfies the, still satisfies the hierarchy identity. The induced superconnection of anamorphism valued differential form is that acted on the curvature that is equal to zero. So because of the Bianchi identity, we can construct characteristic classes not just by using standard connection as we probably have seen on Monday, but we can also construct by characteristic causes by circuit connection. So there is a definition. Suppose we are given a circuit connection. Trend character 4 of the trajectory gradient vector of 1 with a super connection. This denoted by P also depends on the super connection, and it is defined as trace, super trace, maybe I should explain that we are actually taking the difference of the contributions from U plus and U minus. There is a super trace of exponential of minus the curvature. And there is some adjustment according to the degree of differential form. Let me first get back to the main result. The first main result. It is that if I so this is so you see we have an even degree. We have this alternative set degrees. Totally, we have an even object here. And then I raise it to the exponential, it is still even, and then I take kind of choice. So I should remain an even object. But now after the choice, you see, the magic bubble disappeared. So the only even thing is from the degree. So what I get is an even form of B. So I have an even form of B. So first of all, it is closed. And then I can take its Dirac cohomology class. If I take the Dirac cohomology class, I think that it is the term character of this vertical. So this is the even of B, is, let's say, real. So what is the trend character of E? So this needs some clarification. So one clarification. Measuring the difference in character of the positive part and the negative part. And second, there's some adjustment I have to make here. I put a phi here. So what is phi? Phi is a very simple operation. So phi differential forms over B, it is as follows. So it's just on a form with a fixed degree, it's just 2 pi I to the power of minus the degree of alpha over 2 and then times alpha. So if we have a usual connection, the curvature is a two-form, we usually absorb this on the exponent. So if this is just a two-form, then it will be e to the power I over 2 pi, and then the usual curvature, and then take the trace. So this is the just looked off the front of the front of the church.
Okay, thank you.
So let me just give everybody an outline of the proof. Because this is very similar to the proof of the usual Trinitarian form is closed, and its cohomology class doesn't depend on the choice of connection. So we actually sort of repeating the same line of logic. This form, what I get is linear algebra. So you can put this inside, but then you should convert the d to the covariant derivative, and that covariant derivative should be acting on a correct object. So this is an endomorphism valued object. So really, I should be using the commutator. And then by the Bianchi identity, this is zero. So this is exactly the same as the sort of value for usual.